Chapter 505, Seal Broken. The Thunder Crystal Beast was the thunder spirit of the Forbidden Land of Thunder. As the Eye of the Forbidden Land of Thunder's formation, even if a Thunder Crystal Beast wasn't able to slaughter the Eastern Barbarians because of the electrical dampening field, it could still greatly empower Kinlai. Kinlai could sense the Thunder Crystal Beast's aura and understand the expectations it had for him from the electric flames and dazzling lightning bolts. All of the thunder and lightning in the Forbidden Land of Thunder now resonated with Kinlai in a strange way. He could sense with his true soul that all of the electrical energy seemed to have become tame. It seemed that Kinlai was able to control the Forbidden Land of Thunder in the Thunder Spirit's place. Flame Arrow of Seven Dragons. The giant curved bow in Senyi's hands burned with ferocious scarlet fire. An arrow of flame the size of an arm swiftly formed inside the bowl like a scorching pillar of heat. If one were to pay close attention to the flame arrow, they would discover that seven writhing miniature dragons intertwined to form it. Eerie howls continuously echoed from the dragons as the flame arrow burned. Swoosh! Senyi launched the flame arrow, and its seven writhing dragons locked onto Kinlai's aura, rushing toward him with a roar. A terrifyingly intense heat that threatened to burn the world gushed from the draconic arrow. It seemed as if it would overwhelm Kinlai like a sea of fire. Kinlai grinned as flames approached him, their shine reflecting in his eyes. He prepared to activate the frost arc and circulate the refined frost energy in his three frost natal palaces. However, when the flame arrow came within 30 meters of Kinlai, his expression twisted in shock. An unspeakably strange energy entered his Donchan's spirit sea like a formless and shadowless wave. In an instant, all of the spirit energy in his Donchan's spirit sea became chaotic. The thunder, earth, and frost energy in all nine of his natal palaces twisted up into a useless ball. Kinlai actually lost control of his Donchan's spirit sea for a moment, rendering him incapable of summoning a shred of energy to defend himself against the flames that were about to flood over him. This was the same bizarre method that Yan Minutes used. When Yan Minutes and the martial practitioners of the three forces were clashing against each other earlier, anyone who got within 10 meters of him would lose control of their spirit energy. Regardless of how refined or powerful their spirit heart was, that person's spirit sea would fall victim to an abnormal effect and they wouldn't be able to unleash their power. Even powerful spirit artifacts would be reduced to common steel, losing all spirit energies upon entering the giant's vicinity. Kinlai originally thought this was caused by a unique talent that Yan Minutes possessed, and that he was the only Eastern Barbarian capable of nullifying spirit energy. He hadn't thought that Senyi would be capable of the same thing. In fact, Senyi was even more terrifying than Yan Minutes. The flame arrow of seven dragons he fired would disrupt the spirit energy of its targets right before it overwhelmed them. Such a turn of events would surprise even the calmest person, causing them to panic and be flooded by flames. Anyone who fell victim to this would be burned to dust. This method was even more cruel and wicked than Yan Minutes's. Having shot a flame arrow of seven dragons at Kinlai, Senyi no longer paid attention to him. Instead, he turned and shot another one at the Thunder Crystal Beast. He had given up on capturing the Thunder Crystal Beast alive. Now he just wanted to quickly take care of everything inside the Thunder Lagoon. Senyi was very confident that he would succeed. He was certain that Kinlai and the Thunder Crystal Beast would die horrible deaths after firing both flame arrows. These two divine arrows would put a nail in both their coffins. Save me. Every electric flame transmitted the soul cries of the Thunder Crystal Beast. It could sense terrible danger from that arrow. At the same time, since his Donchan's spirit sea was in disarray, Kinlai couldn't use the frost energy in three of his natal palaces. And the seven draconic flames soaring through the air were about to reach him. How could Kinlai split his concentration and try to protect the Thunder Crystal Beast when he couldn't even protect himself? Machiuo. That person cultivates a Thunder Spirit heart. His body will be useful if we preserve it. Remember not to cut his head off, I want his corpse intact. Senyi stared at the Thunder Crystal Beast in the depths of the Thunder Lagoon and snorted coldly, his back to Matu, ZZZT. The buzz of an electric current radiated from the giant silver web, attracting the attention of the Eastern Barbarians. They suddenly realized that Kinlai had struck the web, his body shrouded in flames. The moment the flame arrow came into contact with his body, the seven dragons that formed the arrow had slipped into his body like seven fiery lights. Flames had covered Kinlai's body, and the seven tiny dragons had charged inside of him. He had lost all of his energy and fell toward the bottom of the lagoon. But instead of falling to the lagoon's muddy floor, he had fallen onto the giant silver web. Electricity soaked into his body as he fell through gaps in the web, crashing against thread after thread of metal and descending toward the Thunder Crystal Beast like a fiery meteor. At the bottom of the lagoon, the Thunder Crystal Beast continuously moved around like a bolt of lightning, not daring to stop for even a moment. The other flame arrow chased it like a ray of burning light. It had locked onto the Thunder Crystal Beast's aura, relentlessly pursuing the Thunder Spirit as if it had a mind of its own. The flame arrow of seven dragons was extraordinarily vicious. As soon as Senyi locked onto his prey with his mind consciousness, that poor soul wouldn't be able to avoid it in any way. No matter how much his target ran, if they couldn't forcefully destroy the arrow, they would be pursued until they were struck. Simply dodging it wouldn't put an end to their crisis. Boom boom. Kinlai's flame-covered body slammed into the floor of the lagoon, shattering numerous soul crystals. Damn it. He shattered a lot of soul crystals. What a waste. The Eastern Barbarian swore. Are we almost done? Someone asked Senyi. The Thunder Crystal Beast hasn't collapsed yet. Just wait. Keep waiting. Senyi smiled savagely. Hey, this is good. As long as the Thunder Crystal Beast doesn't stop, neither will my flame arrow of seven dragons. Once I've exhausted all of its strength, I will be able to capture it alive and unharmed. That is the best case scenario. We Eastern Barbarians have finally turned the situation around this trip. We'll kill all the elites of the land of chaos and seize all the precious treasures in the graveyard of gods. Hehe. Next time we invade the land of chaos, we will achieve a historic victory. For too long have we waited for this day. The land of chaos will soon be ours. Those 9 great silver ranked forces, whatever they're called, should have been slaughtered down to last man a long time ago. All of the eastern barbarians above the Thunder Lagoon laughed wickedly from behind a giant web of silver metal. They treated the situation as if everything had been settled, like they'd gained complete control of the forbidden land of thunder. It was clear that they no longer considered King Lion Thunder Crystal Beast threats. Eh? Something's wrong. Matu screamed. The eastern barbarians, all of which were imagining a bright future, looked at him with skeptical eyes. That guy. The flames on that guy's body have gone out. Matu pointed at Kinlai. Every eastern barbarian's gaze turned to the bottom of the lagoon. The flames that had been burning Kinlai's body, which currently lay at the bottom of the soul crystal covered lagoon, actually seemed to miraculously seep into his flesh bit by bit. It was as if he had absorbed the tiny, fiery dragons. Then, although he should have drawn his last breath and been scorched to ash, Kinlai sat straight up. He raised his head and grinned at the eastern barbarians, eyes full of bone-chilling cold. Whoosh whoosh, 2 translucent blood drops of blood emerged from the palm of his left hand, floating into the air and expanding continuously. Matching their increase in size, they burst into flames and grew hotter and hotter. They slowly took on the shape of 2 ferocious fire kylans. Under the utterly shocked gazes of the eastern barbarians, the 2 fire kylans turned into wisps of fiery light and shot forward, enveloping the flame arrow of 7 dragons that was chasing the thunder crystal beast. Like a giant whale sucking tons of water into its mouth, the fire kylans absorbed the intense flames emanating from the 7 intertwining dragons that made up the arrow. Fire kylans. Those are the essences of fire kylan, the first spirit of the forbidden land of flame. Machiuo went pale with fright. He captured the fire kylan in the forbidden land of flames. God damn it. Senyi's face was grim. His earlier confidence instantly disappeared from his face. In addition to that, the fire spirit energy that had been gushing from his body became weaker after Kinlai absorbed the flames of both flame arrows. Shoot him now. Senyi roared angrily. As he did, the third blood essence finished absorbing the flames on Kinlai's body. Then Kinlai coincidentally walked next to one of the logs of Thunderblitz wood. This piece of Thunderblitz wood is the key of the electricity dampening field. Hey. Kinlai smiled, then reached out and touched the giant log of wood. Thunderblitz trees were extraordinary trees that could absorb thunder and lightning. As a result of this unique characteristic, the Thunder Crystal Beast couldn't do anything. Even though it knew that the electricity dampening field could be destroyed as long as the Thunderblitz wood formation was disrupted, there was nothing it could do. The Thunder Crystal Beast was made up of thunder and lightning energy. The only spirit energy it could use was thunder and lightning energy. That was its only attribute. Whether it was the thunder and lightning that circulated inside of its body or the thunder and lightning it controlled separately, the logs of Thunderblitz wood were capable of indiscriminately absorbing all of the thunder spirit's energy. For someone else, moving the wood of a Thunderblitz tree wasn't hard. For the Thunder Crystal Beast, however, such a thing was harder than reaching the highest point in the sky. This was why it hadn't dared to touch any of the 8 logs of wood this entire time. Not only did it not dare to touch them, it basically couldn't touch them because it only had one type of power. Kinlai, on the other hand, was different. Shoot him. Quickly. Shoot him to death. Senyi roared madly. Every eastern barbarian present gathered their strength and attempted to overwhelm Kinlai with waves of fire arrows of all kinds of colors. Unfortunately, arrows formed through the condensation of one spirit energy weren't easy to fire. One needed to spend a decent amount of time to fill the arrows with power. Before any of the barbarians could loose their arrows, both of Kinlai's hands already pressed against the log of Thunderblitz wood he was next to. Rise. Bright yellow halos filled with the immense power of earth erupted from Kinlai's body. Boom. Kinlai forcefully lifted the dark gray log of wood with both of his hands. As his body slowly leaned backward, so too did the wood of a Thunderblitz tree. Eventually, the log of Thunderblitz wood at the center of the formation toppled over, and the giant silver web of metallic threads was instantly torn to pieces. Prack. Countless sparks of electricity and dull explosions flashed across the giant metallic web. Amidst the explosions, the strange energy of the electricity dampening field swiftly fell apart. The lockdown on the Thunder Lagoon quickly vanished. At the other end of the lagoon, the flame arrow of 7 dragons that had been chasing the Thunder Crystal Beast lost its power as the 2 fire kylan flames absorbed it. The Thunder Crystal Beast had finally been saved from disaster. It came to a sudden stop, raised its head, and stared at the giant silver web responsible for locking down its small world up to this point. As the log of Thunderblitz would fell and crumbled to pieces, the Thunder Spirit's shiny, crystalline eyes shone with a cold light. Boom boom, prack. The dull rumbling of thunder resounded from every direction in the forbidden land of thunder. Rainbows of lightning that resembled giant dragons gathered in the Thunder Lagoon like shooting stars. It seemed as if the god of the forbidden land of thunder had become furious and was now intent on cleansing this tainted, filthy world with a baptism of thunder and lightning and eliminating all beings who dared to challenge its might. Retreat. We are leaving this place. Senyi looked into the sky and swore angrily. Yet his eyes still held a look of calm. Senyi knew that the Thunder Crystal Beast had regained control of the forbidden land of thunder, and that the broken metal threads he had brought could no longer be used to form a new electricity dampening field. This meant he could no longer seal the Thunder Crystal Beast's power. Regardless of how reluctant he was or how angry he felt, he couldn't do anything but escape. A horn suddenly resounded, its harsh tone echoing throughout the area. Every barbarian, from the ones inside the Thunder Lagoon to the ones outside clashing with the 3 forces, turned pale with fright as soon as they heard the sound. and they all retreated toward the forbidden land of ice.